how to use a potentiometer to compare resistances. Now the resistances we are supposed to, we are trying to compare are these two resistances. We have RS, which we are called, whose resistance we know. It's a standard resistor whose resistance we know. Of course, when I call it a standard resistor, it means that its resistance is known. Then we have R naught. We do not know the resistance of this, but now we are going to use this potentiometer setup to try to compare these two resistances and hopefully be able to even get the resistor that we do not know. Now in this setup, of course, our normal setup of the apparatus is like that. The driver cell, we have a variable resistor there, P1, then we have the EMF, source of EMF in the secondary circuit. We have these two resistances. But now here the thing is, there are two major steps we are going to be taking. The first step is that we are going to balance this resistor whose resistance we know against this slide wire. So it means that part A is going to be connected to part C, and then this part of the jockey, which we shall call J, is connected to part D, and then we will be able to get the balance length. Now afterwards we shall shift this wire and connect it to part D. This part A will be connected to part D, this and then this wire will be moved to part E, and then we'll be able to balance the potential difference across this resistor whose EMF is unknown, whose resistance is unknown against the slide wire. So the first step, first of all, is to make the connections A to C, and of course this to that. The galvanometer is connected to part D. If I may redraw this diagram, this is how it would look like. We connect part A to part C, and the galvanometer is connected to part D. We tap the jockey of the galvanometer across the slide wire AB up to a point where the galvanometer shows no deflection. When that point is achieved where the galvanometer shows no deflection, we will be able to get measure off the balance length, and then we measure it and record it. Since the balance length we will be getting will be for a resistor RS, a standard resistor, it means we shall call the balance length also LS. And of course at balance, the potential difference across the slide wire, which so happens to be the PD per unit length, which is K, times the balance length LS, should be equal to the PD across RS, which is the current going through the RS, which is I, times the resistance, which is RS. And that's the expression, that at balance, that IRS, which is, this is the PD across the resistor, is equal to the PD across the balance length. That is our first expression. So after that, we'll go ahead and shift our connections. This wire SC will be shifted, and now it will be put at, from A is connected to D. Then this galvanometer is shifted from connecting to this portion to that portion, so that now we balance the potential difference across this resistance, whose resistance we do not know, against that wire AB. If I may redraw this diagram, this is how it would look like. That we shifted this wire and we put it there, connected A to D, and then the galvanometer that was here is connected to point E, so that this resistor, whose resistance we do not know, the potential difference across it is balanced against the slide wire. And of course, we move our slide jockey along that wire. We tap it on different portions along that wire up to a point whereby the galvanometer shows no deflection. When that point is achieved where the galvanometer shows no deflection, the potential difference across that balance length is going to be equal to the potential difference across that resistor R naught. And of course, the potential difference across the balance length is given by K, which is the PD per unit length. Multiply that by the balance length, which we shall call L naught, is equal to the potential difference across this resistor whose resistance we do not know, which so happens to be capital I, which is the current going through that resistor, times the resistance of that resistor R naught. And that is the expression, that I times R naught, this is the PD across the resistor, is going to be equal to the PD across the balance length. Now we have two expressions here. Now that we have this expression and that expression, we go ahead and divide them to be able to compare the resistances. So when we divide expression 1, which is so happens to be that, by expression 2, of course this I and that I will go, this value of K and that value of K will go, we remain with RS over R naught is equal to the balance length, LS over L naught. And from this expression, we are able to get to compare the resistances using the potentiometer. And that is how we compare resistances using a potentiometer. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Feel free to check out other excellent videos on the channel, and don't forget to subscribe.
for Kisembo Academy. This is Arnold Rangakuramia helping you manifest excellence.